Hey guys, morning. So today it's a short tutorial about how to make droney boomerang. Like, I have been getting a lot of questions all the time about how I put those droney boomerangs on my videos. So droneys are old and droneys are like, everyone does it. Here is how a boring droney looks like. And this is how my droney boomerang looks like. Love it, right? So I'm gonna tell you those few steps how you can get it done easily on Final Cut Pro. I'm not going to do a tutorial about Premiere Pro because I do not use it. I have left Premiere Pro since ages, but yeah, it's pretty much easy and straightforward. All you have to do is just go to your drone, get the drone up, point it to your face, and the tip is get the gimbal a bit down. Do not put the camera right on the face, straight on the eye level. Just get the drone up, put it a bit up, get the gimbal a bit down towards your face, make sure it's on focus, and the most important tip, make sure the exposure is right. Stay somewhere around 0.3 or 0.7 plus. That is the best sweet spot for your exposure on your DJI Mavic Pro or Mavic Air or Spark or Inspire or Phantom, anything. So just make sure the exposure is right, the gimbal is pointing a bit downwards. Go to droney, set the distance to the highest possible meters, like 160 meters is what Mavic and Mavic Pro supports. Set it to 160 meters, start the droney, let the drone do its job, let it save the video. Once the video is saved, go to your Final Cut Pro, drag the file to your Final Cut Pro, then the process starts. You need to learn about how to do speed ramping in your Final Cut Pro. Basically, it's the same thing. You have to do the same thing on your Adobe Premiere Pro as well. Just learn how to do speed ramping. So drag the file to Final Cut Pro, then cut out first 2 seconds and last 2 seconds of the droney. That is when the drone takes off, and that is when the drone stops in the end. And both of the times there is a jerk. So make sure the first 2 seconds of the starting and the end 2 seconds are trimmed off. Now you have the final droney file. This is how you need to do it. For the speed ramping, I normally do like three or four seconds is the sweet spot. Then I do the speed ramping. I set the speed somewhere around 800, 1000 or even 2000 depending on the kind of music I have or when the beat I have. So it all depends on your taste and what kind of file your video you are looking to achieve. So just set the first few seconds to let it be a normal 24 fps, and the last or the middle part or the ending part, you need to have it on the speed ramping. Once this is done, this is how it looks. And now you need to just right click, make it as a compound click. Once the compound clip is done, just click on reverse clip. Now you are done with the boomerang. So the starting is the droney taking off, and the second reverse compound clip is droney getting back. So basically no one is going to shoot exactly how it is by droney going off and getting back in the same direction. It's almost impossible to do it. So the best and easiest way to do it is just shoot the droney, reverse clip, put it on the timeline, then speed ramp it. So this is how it looks. Good, right? So that is the most easiest and the shortest tutorial I could have got it done for you guys to know how I do those droney boomerangs. If you have got any questions, just let me know in the comment section below. Smash the subscribe button if you haven't done it yet, and don't forget to click on the bell icon to stay updated. I will see you next time.